This time, Backroads is heading to the heritage-listed town of Braidwood, halfway between Canberra and the south coast of New South Wales. National parks on three sides. It's a town that's enticed and captivated many artists.
I've travelled the world and here I am in tiny little beautiful Braidwood.
And has been immortalised on the silver screen in a few iconic films.
I got into trouble for looking at the camera. So they had to do it again because of me.
Unlike some other country towns, its population is growing, with people seeking a change of pace or simply returning home.
No matter where I've been and what I've done in my life, I've always considered Braidwood my hometown. Anyone who ends up here, they find it very hard to leave.
It's a small town that's not afraid to turn up the volume.
Hello, Backroads. Welcome to Braidwood.
Every year, they hold a festival that celebrates quilts, but not as you know them.
There's a different way to do it, I'll give it a crack.
So you break the rules, really?
Yeah, I do.
Black Range Control, Braidwood 1.
And during the Black Summer fires, when the going got tough, they stood by each other, fighting as one.
Neighbours who weren't talking to each other had generational issues, suddenly side by side defending each other's property. It brought out the best.
I want to find out the secret to what inspires so much creativity in the town, and how that creative spirit helps the community pull together in the most challenging of times. I know this road pretty well. I've driven it many times over the years, from Canberra through Braidwood to the south coast. It remains predominantly a farming district, but it's always attracted outsiders. In the gold rush of the 1850s, thousands of miners moved to the area. Many were Chinese. Nowadays, it's largely artists who are being drawn to the town. Although in Braidwood, an artist often wears many hats.
A little spot.
Well, yeah, this is like little Nepal in Braidwood.
Yeah. What are you making?
I'm making some momo here. This is, a staple kind of Nepali dish, handmade dumplings here. Would you like to come and give us a hand?
Yum.
Karuna is a talented musician and the owner of one of the newer places in town, the Smoky Horse Nepalese Restaurant. And the momo dumplings are a big hit with the locals.
Okay.
So grab a bit of pastry there.
Yeah, okay.
Fold it in and make that little taco shape first. Push it down in the middle there so you've got...
This is not a neat pleat.
That's all right. They're still going to taste good no matter what they look like. Look at that. We'll put it on the menu special.
Born in Kathmandu, Karuna moved to Braidwood with his Australian mum and older brother when he was 2 years old.
It was a bit of a culture shock for my brother and I, coming from a traditional Nepali household to regional New South Wales. We rocked up with his giant golden earrings, brown-skinned boys, so you can imagine the kind of things they used to say to us. And we very much tried our best, I guess, to assimilate.
Braidwood quickly became home, although in the 1980s, it wasn't the vibrant town we see today, earning the nickname Deadwood by some.
I mean, if you gave me a dollar for every time I said, "Mum, I'm bored," yeah, I remember saying that a lot, and we would say Braidwood's a hole and had a lot of bad reps. But, you know, it forces you to become interesting yourself.
Karuna and his brother, Surye, found a solution to their boredom by forming the Bumblebees with other Braidwood teenagers. The band toured globally and in 2004 supported well-known English band Radiohead.
You hit the big time.
Well, for a short period, yeah.
Did you ever imagine that you would come back here after having a life like that?
I think no matter where I've been and what I've done in my life, I've always considered Braidwood my hometown. And I think anyone who ends up here, they find it very hard to leave.
Although he hasn't left the music industry behind completely, the Smoky Horse also doubles as a live music venue, attracting touring musicians, while also supporting locally grown talent.
There's a lot of talent in this small town, and I think I like to share my experiences in the music industry, the highs and the lows, and create a space to achieve their dreams. I feel like there's a value there and a cultural identity that is bigger than us, that is bigger than the restaurant.
I'm genuinely surprised to find such an authentic Nepalese restaurant in Braidwood.
30 seconds for dumplings.
It's incredible to see how much the town has changed since the 80s. It's definitely not Deadwood anymore. At times, Braidwood feels like a film set. The town and its surrounding pastoral vistas are listed on the New South Wales Heritage Register. The only town in the state, and for good reason. The traditional owners, the Yuin people, have lived in the area for thousands of years. But more recently, this unique landscape has been enticing filmmakers. The award-winning 1980s film, The Year My Voice Broke, and the 1970 Ned Kelly were both filmed in the district. As you can imagine, the locals have enjoyed rubbing shoulders with the stars over the years.
I'm a people person, so I like that. I love the pub game.
Jamie Reynolds is a third generation beef farmer turned publican at the Royal Mail Hotel.
What is it that you love about pub life?
Oh, the honesty that grog brings out, and the stories. But I never gossip, ever. I don't repeat hardly anything.
Hardly anything?
No, nothing.
So no gossiping about me, thanks?
No.
As a sprightly 19-year-old, Jamie put his hand up to appear in the Ned Kelly film featuring the famous Rolling Stones frontman, Mick Jagger.
And have you got any photos?
Yeah, I've got a photo.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's over there on the wall. Yeah.
I'll see if I can pick you. Oh, look at this. Local film star.
Yeah, all locals.
Ah, there you are.
Yeah, that's me. Yeah.
Oh, my God. Look at the sideburns, Jamie.
Yeah. Of course, they were glued on.
I remember watching that movie with my parents at the Shepparton Cinema Capri.
Oh, yeah?
And my dad was muttering it was so bad, he got his transistor radio out and started listening to the football.
It was not a good movie.
Good movie or not, it's safe to say that Jamie wasn't the star of the show.
I got into trouble for looking at the camera.
No.
So they had to do it again because of me.
And had you heard of Mick Jagger? Were you a big Stones fan back then?
No, I was more into Slim Dusty and Chad Morgan. I didn't know much about Mick at all, really.
Despite not being a Stones fan, Jamie still managed a chat with the frontman and served Mick his drink of choice, a green ginger wine, in the pub.
Here's to Mick Jagger.
Yeah, to Mick.
Plenty more hit songs yet, even.
Ooh.
Yeah.
She's rocket fuel.
Yeah, it is.
Before rock stars started making their way to Braidwood, the locals entertained themselves with other pursuits. The town's love affair with quilting is celebrated annually with the airing of the quilts.
The festival festival honours that age-old custom of airing bed quilts after the long winter. And it does get very cold here. People flock to Braidwood for this unusual two-day event. Today, many quilters are building on these traditions, forging a new path forward and breaking a few stereotypes along the way.
That's beautiful. Oh, my goodness.
See the same sort of tones going.
The quilt store has been a cornerstone of the town for 30 years.
Oh, I like them.
With Bronwyn Hill taking over in 2019. This doesn't look like your traditional quilt store.
No, no. We try to stretch the boundaries, push the colour. The more colour, the better. There's no such thing as too much colour.
And what were you doing before this?
I worked in the public service, and then I went on to work in the motorcycle industry for 15 years.
That's quite a contrast.
Yeah,
from the public service motorbikes to this.
Didn't give it a lot of thought, I must admit.
Quilting is something you tend to associate with the older generation, mm-hmm. almost an old-fashioned skill. Yep. Is that fair?
No, no. We're trying to encourage younger people, and because otherwise the art will die out. There's a lot of people now enjoying art quilting, which is a completely different style of quilting. The fact that it doesn't have to be perfect, like Grandma used to have to do, there's a lot more leeway for artisticness, I think, and I think that makes them feel more comfortable.
An art quilt is made for hanging on the wall, just like any other piece of art.
I can spend up to a year making an art quilt, and so you don't want the dog laying on them across the bed or something like that.
Bronwyn quilts some rather unique characters, including figures from the Day of the Dead, mythical beasts and reptiles.
Most of my quilts don't stay true to the colour of the animal. I throw a bit more pizzazz. If there's a different way to do it, I'll give it a crack.
So you break the rules, really?
Yeah. Yep, I do.
Not all of the quilters are rule breakers, like Bronwyn, though. The festival encourages everyone to get involved, including the town's youngest quilters. So which ones of these did you do, boys?
That one's my one.
Oh, I like that.
That one's my one.
Work. And Owen and Michael are two students from the local school who made these quilts in their specialist support class. And how did you get the idea?
Well, mind if I step forward?
Of course.
Okay. I had the idea of four different sections, each representing its own shape with its own colour.
Oh, well done.
Red.
With the help of their teacher, who sewed the students' quilts together, they've been able to produce personalised works of art. And did you enjoy it?
Yeah, I very enjoyed it. Just making it and being a part of the community.
How about you, Ando?
I definitely enjoyed it and wasn't as enjoyable as some of the other things we have done, but definitely up there. I'd say, like, top five, maybe six.
Eliza, another budding quilter, is feeling the pressure. So how do you feel about having your work displayed in a public place?
A little scary, because there's some amazing stuff here, but everyone's super kind, so it'll be great.
I love how the festival is ensuring the town's passion for quilting remains alive. I hope the students stick with their new hobby. Who knows? They could be giving Bronwyn a run for her money in the years to come. While the town comes together each year to ensure a successful festival, in the summer of 2019-2020, the community faced an event that would test their spirit. Some of the worst bushfires in our history were raging around Braidwood, and they went on for weeks. Firefighting resources were absolutely stretched to the limit. On the 4th of December, smoke engulfed the small village of Mongalo, 14 kilometres east of Braidwood.
the captain of the local rural fire service, held a meeting, informing the community that no help was coming and they were on their own.
It was a really emotional moment because the captain tells everybody and then he walks behind the whiteboard to have a moment to himself. And it was quite a powerful moment and a kind of big reminder to all of us there that we should step up. We should help in whatever capacity we can.
With no one coming to save them, the locals came up with their own solution, forming the Mongalo Mosquito Army, or Mozzies for short.
So, Adam, what actually is a Mozzie?
So, a Mozzie's basically a farmer or a landowner that has a ute, a water container and a pump. It's an easy way to have a firefighting resource.
Nearly 200 utes across the district joined in the fight. Working tirelessly for more than 2 months, the Mozzies became a firefighting powerhouse, saving properties and lives.
I remember there's a massive fire and I punched in fire corner such and such, such and such, and it all, my phone lit up. There would have been 20 Mozzies responded to it. That's 20,000 litres of water. So the fire got put out.
While on the front line with the Mozzies, Matt started filming what was going on around him.
RFS and the other mosquitoes, and see what we can do to defend Adam's house.
It was an accidental film. I thought, well, I needed to record some of the Mozzies. And then I thought, there's more to it than this.
With the support of the broader creative community, Matt made the feature-length documentary A Community Under Fire.
Do you think Braidwood is a stronger community because of what happened?
Neighbours who weren't talking to each other had generational issues or whatever, suddenly side by side defending each other's property. It brought out the best.
Braidwood Control, Braidwood 1. Be advised to Warrior 1 and Braidwood 1 are now responding.
How does it feel looking back at that now?
I still find it quite an emotional bit, some bits of it to watch. And I notice other people do as well, so. But it's a good record to have, I think, of what we went through.
I guess now we feel like whatever comes over that hill, because of all of us, we're ready, you know? We've got the framework, we've got the community, we've got the good people.
Get in here, mate.
Yeah, fit under your chin.
It's good.
Yeah. Let's go and have a snack. You can still see the scars the bushfires have left behind more than 4 years on. But in typical Braidwood style, the community has found its own ways to heal by drawing on the arts.
Back in town, I'm catching up with a very well-known musician who's been involved in the town's recovery.
We're surrounded by history. There's all these wonderful buildings, the church.
Keith Potger was a member of the internationally acclaimed band The Seekers, and he now calls Braidwood home.
Hey there, Georgie girl, dreaming of the someone you could be. Life is a reality, you can't always run away.
We've got our memories, we've got our friends, we've got our stories, and they'll never end. Every tomorrow.
Keith wrote this theme song for Matt's documentary.
Oh, we've got our friends.
The
title, Memories and Friends, really comes from the film as well, because when your house has been burnt to the ground, what have you got? You've got your memories and you've got your friends.
We've got our memories. We've got our friends.
Keith clearly has a deep connection with this town, and I'd like to know why he finds it so special.
Keith, could you find any greater contrast to life with the Seekers than this?
It's amazing, isn't it? No, I've travelled the world and here I am in tiny little beautiful Braidwood.
And what does Braidwood think about having you in their midst?
That's a good question. What does Braidwood think about having me? No, I have no idea, really. It's a gorgeous thing to be able to just wander down the street. People know who I am, they know where I live, and it's just gorgeous to have so many friendly faces smiling.
What is it that gives you inspiration with your music living here?
I have my own little studio in my house, and what I love to do is to just walk. And so walking around places like this wonderful Ryrie Park, you just go out a little way and you're in wonderful bushland as well.
Do you think that's the case for other creatives here too?
I think it could well be, Heather, because when you find a place that's conducive to creative people, it's sort of like a honeypot that draws people in. And I guess there is that collective feeling that you're among people who have similar interests that will help each other as well. So we learn from each other. That's the other thing about it.
The town definitely embraces newcomers warmly, and the exciting possibilities that they bring. Originally from California, Nate Farrow is putting Braidwood's kids front and centre.
It's been a long-fought community effort to get this underway. It's been over 30 years, really, in the making.
Nate and the other parents saw a need for the skate park after witnessing how the Black Summer bushfires affected their kids.
The bushfires sped up the need for this facility. What they experienced in the bushfire perhaps goes unsaid. You can see they had limited access to their friends, to their school groups, their peers. So having a facility like this after such a catastrophic event has really enabled them to have that connection again. They needed an outlet where they could just be kids again.
With the help of a bushfire recovery grant, the town's kids finally have their skate park and a place of their own.
Can you see the difference in the kids?
Absolutely. You only have to look around me to see the kids, the smiles on their faces. It's quite humbling to be a part of such a project that you can already tell has brought such joy to the masses in this town.
Throughout the whole process, the kids were at the forefront, including the design of the park.
One of the first things that we did is hold a workshop with our young people. Some of them made little cardboard models of features that they'd like to see in their new facility. And then we brought in features that we didn't think were anywhere else in Australia. And so behind me, you see here the wombat hole, which we're calling it, which is probably one of the first overhead loop features in an Australian skate park.
Wow.
Today, skateboarding is an Olympic event, and its popularity is increasing, particularly with females. By the looks of who's using the skate park, all ages can get involved.
I've got a special trick planned for you. You just got to put this on. Just lay down here. You'll be fine.
Nate's 14-year-old son, Skeleton, is going to leap over me on his skateboard. Wish me luck.
Oh, God.
It's just something called an ollie.
Lamb to the slaughter.
Good job.
That's absolutely a first for me. And no bones were broken in the process. I decide to quit while I'm ahead. It's time for something a little more up my street.
A gig.
A gig at the Smoky Horse.
Don't be afraid of those mountain men.
Talent in here tonight has blown me away. So much of it in one little town.
Thank you.
Braidwood has clearly emerged from the Black Summer bushfires stronger than ever. I think I know what the secret is now. Anyone can have a crack at being creative if you're supported by such an inclusive community.
To wanna be crazy, losing my mind. But every day lately seems so fine.
I think Braidwood's just diverse. There's a bit of something for everyone. We're all cut from a different cloth, but we all sort of get along and gather and have a good time.
There's a lot of people in this town that are trying different things and going their own way, which is good. It gives a lot of variety to the community.
Don't want us to be crying.
Braidwood is a much stronger community after the fires. I think the cohesiveness of the town is stronger. It's got a warm, warm feeling to it.
Just reminds us of what we were fighting for. Thank you.
Thanks for joining us on our journey right around Australia. We're already busy filming more fascinating people and places for our next series. Until then, we hope to see you somewhere on the back roads.